In Data Parallel C++, Chapter 3, Data Management. In the Handler class key members. In the next page, you can find class Handler. In this function, you can find memory operation. For example, memcpy destination is on the left hand side, source is on the right hand side. In C and C++ standard, destination is always on the left hand side, source is always on the right hand side. This is C and C++ convention. In the next page, class handler continues. In this class, you can find copy member functions. In this copy member function, source is on the left hand side, destination is on the right hand side. Also, source is on the left, destination is on the right. If we scroll up in the memory copy, destination is on the left, source is on the right. This is the usual C and C++ convention. In case of copy member, source is on the left, destination is on the right. The order of parameters, source and destination of copy member function is reversed, which causes a lot of confusion. I'm not sure if it was designed like this intentionally or is a simple mistake. In this episode, I will discuss Handler class. If we complete chapter 3, we are actually understanding half of SQL. Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is March 4th, 2021. This is 114th episode about vector calculus and classical electromagnetism. In this episode, I will discuss memory operations between buffers, a minor design flaw in SQL handler copy member function. I will also discuss code bloat. If you scroll down, you can find episode 113, implicit dependencies with the accessor and advanced use of buffer. If you haven't watched this video, please watch this video. Otherwise, you may not understand my current session. Scroll down, show more. In the download source code section, please double click this link. Show in folder, unzip it, right click, rename, 114 memory operation. Copy, paste it in your working folder. Start Visual Studio Code. Open your working folder. From folder 114, double click implicit.cpp. Control B. In the test CPU operation, I will make it 100. Control End. I will disable it. In the command prompt, dir cd 114 memory operation dir dpcpp implicit.cpp o d.exe hit enter cls d. So we created array, then we performed operation like this. Or in this function, we can enable it and build again. CLSD. So, right after initialization of array 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, after this operation 2, 6, 12, 20, 30, our operation works correctly. If I change it to 1000, CLS, we build again, it does not work. Note, instantiation of function template specialization requested here. It means our function template specialization cannot be instantiated or created at compile time. This is called code bloating. This operation is defined in this function. Right click, go to definition, operator plus array, array addition is defined here. These are all template functions and it can cause code bloating. I haven't implemented these operations for production level programming. I created these operations for testing purpose to learn SQL more efficiently or conveniently. So understand code bloating, especially when we use template functions. For more information about code bloating, code bloat, please refer to Wikipedia. I created these operations for accuracy. For example, auto bloated, I copy this, paste it here, 1.5, 2.5f, copy this, bloated, I will change it to 200. If we build again, CLSD, please understand that we created array of element type int. In case of bloated, we sent parameter 1.5. This is double. This is float. The result is double. I created these operations for accuracy to debug parallel programming such as SQL or Intel TBB. So code bloating is unavoidable because it generates type on the fly. Bloated is type double. Array is type int. Please understand why I created these operations. Now close these files. Select folder 114, click handler.cpp, hit enter, control V. Sorry, I will copy this part, copy, paste it here, I will close it, control V, void, test, handler, copy, update, host, operations. Int main, copy the function name, paste it here. Const expir, int count, we will assign 10, std, array, int count, array, SQL, buffer, buffer, we associate array, SQL, buffer, int, copied, count, copy once again, paste, squared. Please understand that buffer is associated with array, host array. In case of copied and squared, these are not associated with the host memory array. SQL, Q, Q, SQL, GPU selector. If your computer does not support GPU selector, then you can just remove it. Now, Q, submit. Don't forget semicolon, capture all, SQL, handler, handler, curly brace, SQL, accessor, access. We want to access buffer. Then we need handler. We have to specify device to our access. Sickle, right Tony. Handler, parallel pole, count. This count comes from array count. We capture by value. Inter I, don't forget semicolon. Access, I. We initialized our buffer. We used write only for performance reason. Now here, Q, submit, semicolon. We capture by reference, SQL, handler, curly brace. Now, SQL, accessor, access, buffer. We are accessing this buffer, handler, SQL, read only, SQL, accessor. We are accessing this copy buffer. Access. We provide this buffer. Copied is buffer. Handler. SQL. Write only. Now, handler. Copy. The pulse comes destination. No. The first parameter is source. Source. Target comes on the right. Access. Copy. The first parameter is source. The second is target or destination. It's very confusing. Sorry, I made a mistake here. It should be copied. Q, submit, semicolon. We capture all, SQL, handler, curly brace. Now, SQL, accessor, access, copied. We are accessing this copied buffer. Then, handler, SQL, read only, copy, faced, now scared. We are accessing scared, this buffer. This is write only. Handler, parallel pole, count. We capture by value, int I, curly brace, don't forget semicolon. Access squared I equals access copied I times access copied I we squared each element of copied. Now Q submit semicolon capture all SQL Handler, curly brace. We now copy scared to buffer. SQL, accessor, access, buffer, handler, SQL, write only. SQL, accessor, access, scared. We access scared. Handler, SQL, read only. Handler, copy. The first comes source. This is source. The second is target or destination. Now we update. Q, submit, capture all, SQL, handler, curly brace, semicolon, SQL, accessor, access, buffer, handler, update host, access. Please understand that this access represent our buffer by calling update host member, passing access for buffer scroller. We are updating CPU memory array associated with the buffer. So, stream array processed using GPU and L array and L. Now, in the command prompt, it is handler. Hit enter. Handler. Now we build again CLSD. Array processed using GPU. Now I will make it 100. Then I will copy this paste array CPU SED IOTA array CPU begin array CPU end. We initialize with 0. With this, scroll down auto scaled CPU array CPU times array CPU. Copy this, paste array processed using CPU scaled CPU. Now we build once again CLSD. So array processed using GPU 0149. Array processed using CPU 0149. These are exactly the same. If we do not have debugging tools for parallel programming, our parallel programming can easily go out of hand. If array equal to scaled CPU stream GPU operation is correct, and else GPU operation is incorrect, we can increase, for example, 200. We build again CLSD. Array processed using GPU. Array processed using CPU. GPU operation is correct. Without such debugging tools, debugging data parallel programming is very difficult or hard to implement.